Water, a Precious Resource, Part 1.
Water is priceless, and there is no life without water. Water is not only necessary for humans, but also for plants. All vegetation is dependent on water. What is life if there is no water? Without water, there would be no crops, no fruits, no vegetables, no weeds, nothing. In this video, we shall learn about the importance of water and related aspects. Let us go to a small town in Rajasthan where Jugnu and Rajesh live.
Mother, today our school has an essay writing competition. I shall call Rajesh quickly, otherwise he will get delayed as usual. Rajesh, are you coming?
Yes, you please wait for 2 minutes. I will get ready quickly.
Rajesh, you are late every day. What do you do that you get delayed every day?
Don't you know, Jugnu, there is such a shortage of water in this village? Every morning I bring water from the Sarpanch's house, so I get delayed every day. We have a lot of water problem here.
Oh, we also have a lot of water problem at my house. But mother brings water in the morning and me and sister help her in the evening. Let's go quickly now.
Children, today, March 22 is being celebrated as World Water Day. You all know that there is a lot of water scarcity in our village and in different parts of our country. Today, all of you will write an essay about the importance of water and ways to preserve water. And whoever's essay will be the best, he will get a reward. Children, what is the significance of World Water Day? If you look at the map of the world, you will see that the most of our planet has water, which is about 70%. Despite there being 70% water, water scarcity is still there. Can you think why this is happening? All the children have written very good things about the importance of water. Today's award goes to Jugnu. Jugnu, come here and tell the whole class what you had written.
Yes, sir. Friends, this earth has 70% water. But 97% of this water is salty, which is in the oceans and seas. This water is not usable as it is salty.
Jugnu is right. Only 3% of water is worth using.
Sir, is this why our village is so short of water?
Yes, but can Jugnu elaborate?
This 3% water is called as fresh water. Of this 3% water, about 2/3 of the water is found in rivers, ponds and lakes, and some water remains as groundwater. Groundwater remains inside the earth. The fresh water first gets deposited as ice and glaciers. This then melts and goes into lakes, rivers and ponds. Only 0.006% water is available for usage, which we use for agriculture and manufacturing also.
Is this water enough for the entire population?
Children, so little water is used by more than 7 billion people worldwide. They depend on this 0.007% water. All of us therefore experience water scarcity. Like India, there is a scarcity of water in the world all over. water usage has increased sixfold in the last 100 years.
There are many ways to save water. We should use water very carefully. Water should not be wasted. Every drop should be saved. Water should be reused in the home to save rainwater. Toba and Tanka are being made in Rajasthan, in which water conservation is done. They are like the storage tanks. Khadin is a farming system in Rajasthan. It is a traditional farming system. This protects a lot of water. Everyone should conserve water.
Well done, Jugnu. Can any of you tell me where the water comes from?
When it rains, we get water. Rain is the biggest source of water.
Well done. And how does it rain?
Water occurs in three states. Ice is solid state, water is liquid state, and vapor is gaseous state.
Right. I will draw a picture to explain. The sun heats the water of lakes and rivers and evaporates to form water vapor. When the water vapor cools, it turns into a liquid form. This is called condensation. When more water condenses in the clouds become heavier and it rains. This entire cycle is called water cycle. The water cycle helps to stabilize the amount of water on the earth. But we should use water carefully.
There is a scarcity of water in our village. But there is a lot of water in my grandfather's village. Why does this happen?
It is because there is more groundwater. Where there is more groundwater, there is no shortage of water.
Is groundwater very important?
Groundwater is the most important source of water for us. Water accumulates below the ground between layers of rocks. The upper limit of groundwater at a place is called water table at that location. This level is usually higher in the plains and much lower in hilly areas.
Sir, thank you. You gave us a lot of information. We understood many things about water.
Today you learned about the many aspects of water. In the next video, you will learn about the distribution of water and the decrease in water level. See you later.